Session 2023. Big Five and Ukraine.
Good morning and welcome to RETRO-MELLO Eurovision 2023. I'm Lennart.
And I'm Harry.
Welcome, good morning.
Thank you very much.
And today we're going to go through the Big Five plus Ukraine. Yeah. And the Big Five are which countries, Harry?
It's Italy, it's France, it's Germany, it's Spain, it's United Kingdom, and yes, as you say, Ukraine.
Yeah, because they won last year.
Yes.
Yes. So that's how it goes. Mm. The Big Five directly qualify to the final, so yeah, they don't have to go through the semifinals, which we have already gone through and flipped and flopped the songs.
Yeah.
And we will do the same thing with the Big Five. So we're going to flip, flop, and plop.
Yeah.
So if we both like the song, Harry, what is it then?
It's a flip.
And if we dislike it?
It's a flop.
And if we disagree?
And it's a plop.
Yeah, that's how we do it. So we're going to start off by listening to Italy.
Yeah.
So this year, Italy sends Marco Mengoni singing Due Vite. Marco Mengoni is very famous in Italy. He's been in the Sanremo Festival many times, and he won the Sanremo Festival this year. That's how they choose their Eurovision contest songs. It's almost a classic Italian ballad. Can I say that? Yeah. It's very dramatic, and the Italian language is so beautiful, and it's makes me feel so many feelings. It's a very, very good song. It's a definite flip.
Yes, it's a clear flip. It's a classic Italian melody, as you say. Yeah. I like it a lot as a song, and I love his voice and performance. So it's a clear flip.
Okay, good. We're moving on to France.
Yes.
Évidemment, toutes ces belles promesses que j'entends, ce n'est que du vent, évidemment. Car après le beau temps vient la pluie.
The song number two is from France with the artist La Sara and the song Évidemment.
Yes.
And Fatima Sara Havdi, known professionally as La Sara, is a Canadian singer and songwriter also based in France with parents of Moroccan descent. She's the second Canadian singer to represent France of the Natasha St. Pierre in 2001.
Oh.
You didn't know that?
No, I did not.
Okay, that's new information. I think this is an elegant performance with a stylish singer.
Mm-hmm.
The song is exciting with a lot of good rhythm. I like the chorus refrain especially and the feeling of a classic French ballad.
Yeah,
Mi amore. Flip.
Mi amore.
Flip.
Yes, it's a flip for me too. I like the way it builds and I like the beat and everything, she's like super cool. I do, however, wonder what it will be like live because I've only seen the video, but I'm sure she will do it great and it will be very, very good. So, definite flip.
Very good.
Sudden glitter, sweet and bitter, we're so happy we could die. Blood and glitter.
So next up is Germany, and the band is called Lord of the Lost, and the song is Blood and Glitter. Lord of the Lost is quite a famous band in Germany. This song has reached number one in Germany. They are a group that formed in 2007, and they have had many members since then, so they seem to come and go a bit. But that's all about that. Now about the song. I love the title, Blood and Glitter, but I don't really like the song. And mainly it's because this is like a metal song, and that's not the thing that usually gets me going. Mm. So, no, this is a flop, I'm afraid.
Yes, it's a clear flop for me. It's like death metal or something. and it's the Lord of the Bad Song. Blood and Glitter Can Go to Hell with a Melody. I wouldn't mind, so it's a flop. Song number four is from Spain with the artist Blanca Paloma and her song Ea Ea. Blanca Paloma is a Spanish singer, set designer and costume designer. Yes, and she's a singer also.
Yes.
This is an exciting ethnic song from Spain. I think I should like it more than I do, mm-hmm. but I find myself being a little bit annoyed by it. This is probably nothing I would listen to or like in the end of this year, so I must flop it.
Okay, it's a flip for me. Mm. This is a song in this year's Eurovision. A lot of things sound the same. Yeah. This one sticks out. This is an original thing. This is like she's so her voice is so. I find it very captivating.
Yeah.
So I like this song. So it's a plop.
Okay. Our first.
Yes. So from Ukraine comes the artist or band known as Tvorchi, and the song is Heart of Steel. Mm. Tvorchi is quite popular in Ukraine. They have been around since 2018. This song actually won the public vote in the Ukrainian contest, but the jury vote it came second in. It's so hard to know how I feel about this song, because I really like the refrain, but I'm not so sure about the verses, and it feels like it's going somewhere, but it's never quite there for me. So I'm afraid I have to flop it.
Yes, I'm sorry, I must flop it, even if it's Ukraine. This is a nice melody with a slow rhythm. I find myself comparing it to the Ukrainian song from last year.
Yes.
And I like this also as much, but it's probably not nothing which will grow a lot more, I think. So it must be a flop for me.
Yes. So we're moving on to the last one, which is the United Kingdom.
Yes. Song number six is from the United Kingdom with the artist Mae Miller and the song I Wrote a Song. And I Wrote a Song is co-written by Mae Miller herself with Karen Poole and Lewis Thompson.
Yes.
About the song, I like the video and I think the lyrics suits the melody very well. And most important of all, the song is quite melodic, with a nice verse and effective chorus refrain. So it's a flip.
Yes, it's a flip for me too. This is like a traditional pop song.
Yes.
And it's quite modern, so yeah, no reason not to like it. It will be interesting, however, to see how they do it live.
Yeah.
Because we've only seen the video. But I think the UK has a pretty good song this year. Now we've gone through all the six songs. Let's see and speculate a bit how they will do in the final.
Yes.
Big Five and Ukraine. So out of these six songs, how do you think they will do in the final? Starting off with Italy. How do you think it will go, Harry?
It will come top 10, I think.
Yes, I think so too. Mm. Definitely top 10.
Yeah.
Not so sure about top 5.
No.
But something there.
Yes.
Yes. Mm. Yes. Pretty sure about that.
Yes.
What about France?
Also top 10. Maybe top 5.
I'd say top 15.
Oh,
I'm not so sure about France.
Are you sure?
I like it, but I'm not so sure.
I like it very much.
It wouldn't surprise me if it were top 10, but it can also place it Number 12 or something. I'm not sure.
I like it even more than Italy, I must add to it.
Okay. Oh, nice. Yeah. What about Germany?
Bottom 30.
Yes, I think out of the 20, I think it's 26 songs in the final. This is below placement 20, I think.
Yeah.
I think.
I'm sorry.
But you never know. You never know. Maybe all the metalheads out there gather together and vote for...
Yeah, maybe this is their only alternative song.
I'm not sure. I can't do anything right. So, Ukraine then, how do you think they will fare?
I'm sorry to say, I don't think they will win, but maybe top 10?
Yes, and I think they will get, like last year, they will get a lot of votes because of the situation in Ukraine, as they should maybe, but I don't think this is... a winning song like last year. So this is top. I think definitely top 10 though.
Yeah, I think so.
Due to the circumstances. Yeah. Yes. Mm. And finally, what about the UK?
I think it will be a very good top 10.
Yes. Yeah. And I think also because it's set in the UK this year in Edinburgh.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Liverpool. I think it will be doing pretty good, and it's a good song. So, but it's not in my books. It's not a winning song. No. So, but it's top 10.
Absolutely. And Lennart, we forgot Spain.
Yes. Yeah. What about Spain?
you can say first because I think you like it.
Yeah, I like it. I think Spain is definitely top 10 for me.
Okay. Mm. For me, maybe top 15.
Yes. Mm. But I can say that all these songs, the big five plus Ukraine, I wouldn't say that any of the songs were truly bad.
No.
But then on the other hand, I don't think any of the songs is a winning song.
Of these six songs. The only one I would like to win or think could win is France.
Yes.
For me.
Yes. Yeah. I would say if I had to choose something, it's France or Italy.
Yeah.
But I don't know, but I don't think this is the winning song.
No, I think this that the winning song is in semi-final one.
I think so too.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was the big five plus Ukraine.
Yeah.
We're heading towards May and the semi-finals and everything else.
Yeah.
But this is it. Now we've gone through all the songs for Eurovision 2023. Yeah. And we say thank you for listening.
Yeah, thank you.
Goodbye and see you soon.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.